Alright guys, I wanted to make a video for you today. I'm going to do problems number 4 and 6 from today's worksheet. That was the worksheet that had the word problem on the bottom that we did together in class. So we're going to do number 4 and number 6. So number 4, I have 8r squared equals 4 minus 8r. This is not in standard form. I need everything to be on the same side of the equals. So I'm going to move this 8r squared to the other side. So it cancels it here, leaving 0. And 8r squared, that's my ax squared value, so it's going to go first. Minus 8r is my b value. And my c value is 4. That's a positive 4 because there's no sign in front of it. Okay, so now I'm in standard form. I can pull out a, b, and c. A is negative 8, B is also negative 8, and C is positive 4. Once we've got that, we're going to plug this into our quadratic formula. So we got X equals negative B plus or minus the square root. B squared minus 4AC, all divided by 2A. So I'm going to set it up negative B plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, all divided by 2 times a. I'm going to go back and I'm going to plug in the numbers that belong. So this is supposed to be a b here, and b is negative 8. B also goes here. This is an a value, which is negative 8. This is c, which is 4, and this is a, which is negative 8. Once everything's plugged in, our next step is to start simplifying. So my very first thing, I've got negative, negative 8. Well, that's a positive 8, so I'm going to put positive 8 here. Then we have plus or minus a square root. I want to find what my discriminant is. So I want to take my calculator. Okay. And I'm going to put in what I have here for my discriminant, parentheses, negative 8 squared minus 4 times negative 8 times 4, and that's going to give me 192. So my discriminant is 192. That's a positive number. That means it's two real solutions, and it's all going to be over negative 16. So I've got to start breaking down 192. So I could say 2 divided by 2 because I see it's even, but that I'm going to be dividing for a long time. So I'm going to go look in my y equals. I'm going to put 192 divided by x and go look at my table of values, and I'm just going to pick something bigger. I see there's 3 times 64. And the thing about 64 is I know 64 is a perfect square. So here's why I would want to do that. 3 times 64, and then 64 is 8 times 8. So I have a pair of 8s, which means 1's going to come out. The 64 we already used to right here, and we have this 3 left over. So he's going to stay underneath the radical. So I get to simplify down to 8 plus or minus 8 root 3 divided by negative 16. Okay, now our final step here is there is no way 8 and 8 root 3 are combined. They're not like terms. So we just need to look towards simplifying. We want to look at the three numbers on the outside of the radical right here. 8 and negative 16. So 8 and negative 16, they all have 8 in common. So when I reduce it, I'm really dividing each one of these by 8. So for my final answer, I got 8 divided by 8, which is 1. We got plus or minus. 8 divided by 8 is 1 again. The root 3 is not going to change. And negative 16 over 8 is negative 2. And usually what happens is we don't leave this negative sign down here. We're just going to pop him up there. And we'll rewrite it. Negative 1 plus or minus. We don't have to have the one right there, root 3 over 2. That's where your x-intercepts are going to be. So hopefully this was a helpful problem. If you have trouble with these, you can always stop and restart the video, which is a really good way to be watching these. So that was number 4. Let's go ahead and do number 6. So number 6 was nice because it's already set up in standard form. There's my ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So my a value is 7, b value is 8, and c value is negative 20. So I'm going to plug it into my quadratic formula. So I have negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, and that whole thing will be divided by 2a. Okay, so we'll plug in. This is supposed to be a b, which is 8. This is also b. This is a, which is 7. C is negative 20. And a is 7. Okay. Once it's completely set up, all that's left to do is to start simplifying. So I have negative times 8, so that's negative 8, plus or minus the square root. All right, so let's take out our calculators, and let's find out what this number is. I have 8 squared minus 4 times 7 times negative 20. And I'm going to get 624 divided by 14. So 624, that's one of those big numbers. I'm going to go look in here, and I'll go put 624 divided by x. Go look at my table of values. And I want to look, see if I notice anything right off that is a perfect square. I don't really know for sure. I don't see anything that's jumping out at me. So any pair, you can start with any pair. How about 12 and 52 for no reason other than because it's right there. So 624 will break down to 12 times 52. 12 will break down to, there's a couple different ones. I'm going to use 3 and 4. 4 will break down again to 2 times 2. Remember, once you break it down, you can't use that number again. It's all gone. So we've got 3 times 2 times 2. That would take us back to the 12. The 52, we can do 2 times 26, which is 2 times 13, and 13 is prime. Okay, so I've got, what do I have here? I have a pair of 2s. I have a pair of 2s. And I have a single 3. And I have a single 13. So the singles have to go back under the radical. Remultiply them together and you get 39. On the outside, I'm going to bring out 1, 2, and the other 2. So on the outside, I'm going to have a 4. So let's substitute this in. At negative 8 plus or minus 4 square root 39 all over 14. And then like we did on the other one, we need to check all of these outside numbers, outside the radical numbers, to see if they reduce by the same amount. It looks like they all have a 2 in common. And what that means is we're going to divide each of these by 2. So negative 8 divided by 2 is negative 4, plus or minus 4 divided by 2 is 2, square root 39, divided by 14 divided by 2 is 7. So my x-intercepts or my zeros or my roots or my solutions, whatever you want to call them, this is going to be the answer. So hopefully that helps clarify. Tomorrow we'll do some more work with this and some factoring and solving and all that other thing that we've done before as we review for your quiz on Friday. See you tomorrow.